in this August House to lend my support to the COVID-19 response bill, Mr. Speaker. And of course, I wish to congratulate the Honourable Attorney General and Minister for Economy and his team for providing us with this budget that should allow us to effectively respond to the current COVID-19 pandemic. Provide relief for all Fijians during these trying times, and of course, provide stimulus to the Fijian economy. Let me just, without highlighting the area specifically, particularly for the RFMF and for the Fiji Police, but as Minister responsible for national security, Mr. Speaker, sir, may I just compliment what the Honourable Minister for Health has already stated before this August House. Let me again congratulate all the health officials led by the Minister for doing such an excellent work within the areas of the key activities that particularly is very much health related. But I think in terms of where we are now and the plan that we have, let me again reassure the Honourable Leader of the National Federation Party that government has a plan. And of course, consistent with the models that are set by the World Health Organization, we, however, have contextualized the model that they have. And of course, this is all about working within the framework of the emergency management framework that we already have in existence in the country. And of course, in the major areas of the cycle of emergency management, prevention, preparedness, response, and of course the recovery. And of course, fundamental to that, Honourable Speaker, sir, is the risk assessment or the threats, and of course the corresponding levels of action that needs to be undertaken by government. Of course, we need to have a gradual or a proportionate response to the effects of COVID-19. Let me make some comments on the issue that was raised by the Honourable Leader of the Opposition and of course the Honourable Rendondo as well about the closure of our border in what the Honourable Leader of the Opposition referred to as our preemptive measures. Of course, we can come with those early decisions earlier on. But Mr. Speaker, sir, it's not only about the economy and about employment, but most importantly, one thing that we consider seriously and number that were returning from India for medical treatment, but were denied entry into Samoa. We have to look after them. Secondly, Mr. Speaker, sir, we are the transportation hub of the Pacific, and we work very closely with Australia and New Zealand because we also have a responsibility to look after our own Pacific communities and neighborhood. They connect to the other parts of the world through Fiji. And of course, we also have a responsibility, not only during good times, but as a responsible neighbor, and of course, as a responsible country, being the hub of transportation in the region, we also have a responsibility to bring them back into their respective countries as well. Mr. Speaker, sir, let me assure the Honorable Leader of the Opposition and all the honorable members on the other side of the House, there are risks. But risks can be reduced, risks can be transferred, mitigated, or managed. And that is what we have been doing until we became the 164th country to have COVID-19. Mr. Speaker, sir, levels of action. We need to take proportionate response. Let me again mention that the Ministry of Health is doing very, very well and effectively in the areas in which they are solely responsible for. Screening at the borders, the detection and the testing. Of course, they also have a big part in the tracing of contacts, and of course, in the isolation of the challenge that we have now. And this is the opportunity for me to plead to all Fijians, it's the comprehensive approach. Comprehensive approach is the responsibilities and actions by all other stakeholders apart from health. And this needs not only a whole of government approach, but a whole of society approach. I've mentioned it so many times in this Honorable House, Mr. Speaker, sir. National security is a whole of nation, whole of society approach. We all have to take responsibility. People are acting irresponsibly. Let me say, Mr. Speaker, sir, the planning teams are there, but let me assure this Honorable House, this is about containment. Containment is the key word in our operations now. And that containment comes in two forms, the isolation and the quarantine. We do the isolation and the quarantine well, we kill COVID in Fiji, Mr. Speaker, sir. And there is no need to lock the whole of Fiji. We lock the threat through isolation and quarantine. That's the end of COVID in Fiji. And of course, let me urge everyone up, let's have confidence in our own processes and systems and the expertise that we already have within. We will do well if we work together. The comprehensive approach, every community, every individual in this country must act together. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir.
Thank the Honourable Minister. I give the floor to the Honourable Honoré Chale. You have the floor, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir, for allowing me the opportunity.